Will Node.js die? I'm asking this question because Deno is here. So what I need to learn, Deno or Node? I will answer this question at the end of the video, but first let's see actually what is Deno. So if you are familiar with Node.js, if you know what Node can do for you, I can introduce you with Deno, and I can say Deno is deeply improved version of Node. Node and Deno are closely related because Randall has created Node.js in 2009, a decade before, and now the same Randall is having another runtime built for JavaScript called Deno. And the exciting part is Deno stable version 1 is now released on 13th May 2020. So Deno is actually a secure runtime for JavaScript and TypeScript. Just like Node.js, it can be used to create the server application. The Deno is written in Rustlang and TypeScript and uses the same V8 engine that is powering Node.js to transcode the JavaScript into machine code. So if you visit the Node.js website, it says Node is a JavaScript runtime build. And if you visit the Deno website, it says a secure runtime for JavaScript and TypeScript. Here, I want to emphasize on two words. One is secure, another is TypeScript. So these two things are inbuilt in Deno. You don't have to worry about these things. But now let's focus on the key features of Deno. Why Deno is so famous? Deno is super famous because it is very, very secure. No one can access anything unless allowed, not even the developers. Yes, not even the developers. No file, network, or environment access are available until explicitly enabled. If you are trying to run a Deno code, then you will get error if you have not given any permission. You need to run these options like allow environment, allow network, allow plugin, and various things. It is very famous because it uses the decentralized system. Consider package.json, which works with the centralized npm system, and npm is managed by some company or industry, nowadays by Microsoft. But Deno take a different approach. Deno fetches all the packages from just the URL or from your local disk. This means you can create your package and without worrying to publish on any centralized place like Node website, and you can directly play with your package. You can have tons of official and third-party package for Deno that will help you to build some great applications. Because it is uses a decentralized system, there will be no package manager. That means no node module, no package.json, and no npm install. Let's take an example code. Here, this code is for creating the server. And you can see here, we are importing the server directly from the URL, directly from the Denoland standard library of server. And that's an amazing thing. So if you try to run this server, it's going to first download everything, and then after that, whenever you try to run the same code, it's not going to download it again and again, because first time it download and caches, and every time you ask for that package, it give you that from your caches. And that's an amazing part. Deno is also super famous because it uses the modern JavaScript. In modern JavaScript, the ECMAScript works out of the box in Deno, and promises are inbuilt in Deno. So you don't need to define async to use the await. Let's take the same example once again. Here you can see we are using await without defining any async. And next, it is so famous because it supports a TypeScript. You know, many developers consider TypeScript as the future of JavaScript. And now TypeScript is inbuilt in Deno. That means you don't have to worry about the compiling the TypeScript code. Deno does all the work for you. There will be no TypeScript configuration file, and this doesn't mean you cannot use the normal JavaScript. You can use, but because there is TypeScript support and TypeScript is very great, that's an amazing move. Next, Deno is super famous because it uses the single executable file. It creates a single executable file. You can run program without any dependencies. And once you have downloaded all your dependencies, you can work on the airplane mode also. Deno is also famous because you don't have to pull any external library for your testing, because Deno has its own testing module. Deno is very, very developer friendly because it has its own dependency inspector and code formatter called Deno FMT. You don't need any prettier to format your code. That's again, once again, a great move. And last but not the least, the super important thing Deno has is its support for the WebAssembly. There are many packages which will help you to create the WebAssembly things with the Deno, and you can use it to build an amazing thing. But now let's talk about what's the problem with Node.js. Why Dal created Deno? So Dal actually left Node on 2012 when he reaches the goal of creating a server application using JavaScript. Then after he realized that Node is a mistake, lots of things he regretted about this, and he has mentioned everything on this JavaScript conference, and you can find the link in the description. But I will tell you every mistake he had on Node. First, the most important mistake is not sticking with the promises. When Node was written, there was no concept of promises, there was no async and await, and that's why Node doesn't have any async and await system inbuilt. Next mistake was the insecure. Node is super insecure. If anyone by mistake get the access of any of your Node file, he can access all of your server. Everything is open for everyone with one single door. That's a very bad thing. Next mistake is package.json. You know, in package.json, whatever package you have defined is available in npm place, is available in node module, is available in your files. Why redundancies? And the most problematic thing is algorithm to resolve a package is super complex in Node.js. Next mistake he had is the build system. Node was written in C, C++, and GYP was used to compile all C codes. Initially, GYP is used by Google in V8, but later it dropped the support. But because Node.js was written initially with the GYP, only Node is using it. So these were the mistakes Dal had, and that's why he had created the Deno. Now let's answer the two questions I have asked initially. First, what should I need to learn, either Node.js or Deno? I would say don't rush towards the latest technologies. If you know Node.js, that's enough. But if you are going to start with Node, I would say start with Deno, because Deno is the future. And that leads to the second question is, will Node die? I would say the answer is yes, but that will take at least 2 or 3 years to die until Node is going nowhere. But because Deno is covering all the flaws of Node.js, Deno is the future. So once again, if you are going to start with anything, then start with Deno instead of Node.js. If you know Node.js, you need to learn Deno slowly so that after 1 or 2 years, you will become the master of Deno instead of Node.js. So now let's welcome Deno and start learning it.